Yeah, this is my son, Nick Buzz. He's gonna fly a giant arrow video plane again. Okay. We got a pretty good wind here today. I ain't got a helicopter left. What kind of helicopter?
I don't know. I think it's really
electric or glow?
No, it's got motor.
Alright.
32, I think.
32. I don't really mess with the glow stuff anymore, Doug, you know. I don't think I ever will, you know. It's too much trouble. You had to work them all the time.
Got two FM radios.
Yeah.
Been a good sport for me through the years.
Yeah. Still got 11 bolts in that radio.
It's amazing those LiPo batteries.
Right. It's about this big, about this long, Doug. About that big. Little 3-cell.
What it cost to convert to LiPo, you think?
All you do is just get your one and plug it in.
Really?
That's all you do. Now you got to take it out to charge it.
Yeah.
You can't charge it with your regular charger. You know, cheapbatterypacks.com has them.
9.6 volts.
No, 11.1 volts.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, 11.1 volts, 800 milliamps. Lasts forever. Charge it. You know, you charge it till the light turns green. You know, like you're on your LiPo charger, and then put it in there. I mean, you don't have to worry about it going down on you.
You know, why not? See, I go out flying. I'll fly 3 or 4 airplanes.
Right.
Or at least 2.
Uh-huh.
And I'll recharge them a couple of times on the field.
Right.
And always run out of battery on the radio.
Uh-huh.
And I won't fast charge it on the field.
Yeah.
I just don't trust it.
Right.
Nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, I've only fast charged the transmitter a couple of times.
Yeah, I've done it a couple of times.
Yeah.
On a long, long day, you know.
Beautiful.
Well, you can probably change the motor for less than $50.
The battery from cheapbatterypacks.com for your transmitter is about $25.
I think I've got some 50% discount coupons.
Wow. Yeah. Now, if you change your planes over to LiPos, you gotta use a regulator. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't want to throw anything more than, you know, 10 and a half boats at your receiver. That's what they say, you know. But, you know, it don't really make any sense because...
Well, I usually put, what is it, 5 or 6 batteries in there?
The seed, the all-electric stuff, my helicopters, they 11 volts. Yeah. 11.1 volts.
Man, I can't even do it. I'll be every shot. I think I usually run 6 volt batteries. That's what I run my flight.
Right. Yeah.
You know, on low airplanes.
Uh-huh.
I usually run 1,300 milliamps.
11 to 1300. Right. I'm a little bitty helicopter using 11.1 volts to fly them.
Yeah. I don't understand that. I'll charge them suckers up, and every time I check them, it shows I got 6 volts, and I'll fly them for an hour.
Uh-huh.
And it'll still say I got good batteries.
Right.
So I don't trust them, you know. Get the smallbattery.com.
Yeah. Good. Low pass, but man, I ain't believing how good a video that iPhone takes.
You would, I just see, I couldn't even see the airplane through my screen.
Yeah, if they had a brighter screen on it, boy, I'll tell you what they'd have.
Well, what it is, it's my shield, to be honest with you. The plastic covering.
Oh, covering, yeah.
See, it should have a mirror shield on
it. Right. Keep you from scratching it?
Yeah. And I don't have one. I'm too cheap to buy one. To be honest with you.
See it wind hit it?
But the way you were flying.
Right there in that turn. Did you see that?
This was flying a little bit further.
Something happening to them, right, Nicholas?
I love helicopters, but I couldn't afford them, number one.
Oh, yeah.
Number two, I couldn't fly.
Yeah.
That's why I couldn't afford them.
It did make me a better RC airplane pilot.
Yeah.
Because
it didn't.
Right. Because you got to learn to use that rudder, man, and now I don't, every time I turn, I'm coordinating it. You know what I'm saying?
Well, see, everybody quit flying with me. I guess I stumped or something.
They quit over there altogether, though, Doug.
Yeah, everybody quit flying out of my neighborhood, and I didn't have nobody to fellowship with.
Right.
It ain't no fun to crash by yourself.
It ain't. You know,
David
I love
and Sammy to come out that way, though, right?
David and Sammy? David and Sammy? The crash dummies? David Turner and Sammy Ingram.
No, I know their names from somewhere.
You met them out here. They used to fly with us.
I just don't like crashing by myself.
Yeah, I hear you. Oh, David, he got...
That last old boy I had that mid-air with, he just seemed like he was aggravated with me. And, you know, offered to buy the airplane. And,
uh-huh.
Even though it wasn't my fault. I hadn't seen him since.
Right.
Who, what was that?
Oh, we was flying formation. It was both of our ideas. He run into me. I felt bad about it. His dad died that night.
Yeah, I remember you told me that.
Yeah, I guess he got aggravated with me. His dad said, "Wow, how do y'all keep running into each other?" I said, "All that never happens."
And then you run into
it. Next thing we do, we run into each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the way.
Give me a landing buzz and I'll stop it. Then you can fly some more, man.
All right. But you know, I was able to land and he was able to land too.
Really? So it didn't total him, right?
No, it didn't total either airplane. Knocked his wing saddle loose and he had about a 6 degree up thrust.
Right.
My tail feathers off.
Right.
I did knock it completely off.
Knock them loose. Beautiful. All right, there you go, Buzz. This is my son, Nick Buzz. Just made another flight on Able RC Giant aerial video plane with the Cub Cadet engine that I converted. I want to thank everyone for watching. God bless. Take a bow. Thumbs up, Buzz. All right.